That's good. A huge Connecting for Change East Coast Bioneers welcome to Kenny Ausubel.
Thank you, thank you. I can't see a thing. We're blinded by lights up here. So as Golda Meir said, don't be so humble. You're not that great. So I'll follow Golda. So it's really wonderful to be here and incredibly inspiring to me. It feels like a little bit of a paternity suit or something. And it's remarkable to see the seeds that you've planted here and what the Marion Institute and Bioneers by the Bay has done in concert with the community of New Bedford and the greater area here. I mean, I'm sincerely astonished and inspired. And in fact, as Bioneers National, we have prioritized the Beaming Bioneers Community Conference program going forward. And we're in very close dialogue with many of the communities. And I'm going to be coming back here in a couple of weeks to actually roll up our sleeves and understand how we can all work more closely together to really move this movement further out and further deeper all the time. And I've just got like 5 or 7 minutes now, and what I thought I would like to do is give you just a very short excerpt of part of the talk that I gave at the Bioneers National Conference last week. So that's what I'm gonna do. And then I hope to see you at the book signing or at the workshop later. In this epic moment of radical environmental and social disruption, we're experiencing the dawn of a revolutionary transformation. We're becoming a civilization that's ecologically literate and socially just. The existential gauntlet is to make the shift fast enough to outrun global cataclysm. The next 5 or 6 years are going to be the once-in-a-civilization window to actually change course. We can move from breakdown to breakthrough. The Mayan people call this the time of no time. From here on, we're on Earth time. Mother Earth is shaking to her core. It's a time of madness, disconnection, and hyper-individualism. It's also a time when new energies are coming into the world, when people are growing a new skin. The Mayan vision says we in the West will find safe harbor only if we can journey past a wall of mirrors. The mirrors will drive us mad unless we have a strong heart. Some mirrors delude us with an infinity of reflection of our vanity and shadows. Others paralyze us with our terror and rage, feeding an empire that manufactures our fear into resignation. But the empire has no roots and it's tumbling all around us. In this time, everyone is called to take a stand. Everyone is called to be a leader. To get beyond the wall of mirrors, the final challenge is to pass through a tiny door. To do this, we must make ourselves very, very small, to be very humble. Then we must burrow down into the earth where indigenous consciousness lives. On the other side is a clear pond. There, for the first time, we'll be able to see our true reflection. In this time of no time, we can go in any direction we want by dreaming it. Our dreaming can shift the course of the world. Paradoxically, the crisis confronting us today is precisely the dream of our current civilization. That dream of endless growth, hyper-individualism, and domination has turned into a nightmare. How do we dream our way out of a nightmare? Well, one way is to wake up. All over the world, people are awakening to a new dream. It's a revolution from the heart of nature. We're reimagining a civilization in the age of nature that honors the web of life, each other, and future generations. And it's really simple when you boil it down. Taking care of nature means taking care of people, and taking care of people means taking care of nature. For decades, brilliant scientific and social innovators such as the Bioneers have been patiently creating the shadow systems for how we live on Earth for the long haul. For the most part, the solutions are already present or we know what directions to head in. It's not that we need more solutions. We need to rapidly spread and scale what we've already got. We need to mobilize at the scale we've previously done in times of war. It's emergence in an emergency, or as the talking heads put it, this ain't no party, this ain't no disco, this ain't no fooling around. Nature does not favor centralization because one shock can crash the whole system all at once. Climate change, compounded by the concentration of wealth and the distribution of poverty, is pushing natural and human systems to a perfect storm of tipping points. That's the nub, boom and doom, the final throes of an oligarchic economic system bedeviled by its original sin of unlimited growth on a finite planet. One key is to build resilience from the ground up through a radical decentralization of our infrastructure, energy, and food systems. It means a greater devolution of political power to local and regional levels. It means democratizing wealth and access to capital. It means democratizing democracy. It's doable based largely on what we already know. Our greatest resilience resides in community. Social ties literally save lives. In Japan, the government sponsors small local festivals for people just to meet each other because experience shows they'll be better prepared to weather crises and disasters. San Francisco, Santa Barbara, and Seattle are following suit. The Department of Homeland Security just completed funding a successful 3-year FEMA pilot project in 8 cities to create a whole community resilience system for disaster prevention. As Sarah Kroll said, the way we'll hold it together is to hold it together. The hardest thing to change in a system is the paradigm, yet that's exactly what we're seeing. Imagine catalyzing a massive shift to Los Angeles becoming a sustainable city by 2021. Imagine reworking the city as a functioning community forest model of an urban watershed. Imagine biomimicking the forest as the pathway to sustainability in water, energy, air, and transportation. Imagine inspiring, engaging, and supporting 1 million Angelenos and families in changing their homes and neighborhoods. Imagine everybody becoming a manager of the ecosystem. Imagine an integrated ecosystem management team, a board of chiefs among infrastructure agencies to create sustainability. Imagine there's enough money by reallocating existing funds and that it rebuilds the economy and jobs. Imagine a community and multi-agency collaboration, bottom-up and top-down, to adapt LA rapidly before the crash. You don't have to imagine it. Andy Lipkus and Tree People are doing it. Imagine a partnership between a college and its Ohio Rust Belt hometown to go carbon neutral by 2020. Imagine an agroforestry belt that can grow 70% of the community's food locally. Imagine combining these with an emerald green arts downtown redevelopment that models an economic driver for the entire region. Imagine leveraging this template of a town-gown partnership to mobilize the nation's 4,100 colleges and universities in partnership with their communities. You're imagining David Orr's Oberlin project, and $60 million is making it real right now as we speak. Imagine 142 communities comprising over 350,000 people adopting corporate rights elimination ordinances that give communities the right to refuse to recognize corporate constitutional rights. Imagine Pittsburgh becoming the first major municipality to adopt a community bill of rights and enforce it by banning fracking and corporate rights within the city. Imagine these same communities driving rights for nature into their ordinances. Imagine it spreading to Ecuador as the first country in the world to recognize in its national constitution the rights of ecosystems to, quote, exist, persist, regenerate, and evolve. The Community Environmental Legal Defense Fund, led by Mari Margill and Tom Lindsay, is already doing this. Imagine a new regional model of development, such as an environmental bank that keeps your money in your region and gives loans to the people who grow your food. Imagine a forest fund that manages forests for timber, jobs, conservation, and carbon sequestration. Imagine it makes a financially attractive return. Imagine buying industrial forest land and growing trees for their own sake because they provide habitat and carbon sequestration, and eventually bigger trees to sell in better markets. Imagine returns attractive to investors who see the value of storing wealth in natural capital and want a return for their kids and grandkids. You're imagining EcoTrust and Spencer Beebe and Astrid Schultz in the Pacific Northwest. Just imagine disrupting our current institutions by giving people these better choices. Imagine proliferating these kinds of winning institutional innovations rapidly around the world. Imagine an infrastructure that shortcuts these innovations and gets the world's social entrepreneurs access to existing ideas and capital much more quickly. Imagine a global action network of resilient communities. Imagine that. And we just held a big event at Bioneers last weekend, a one-day intensive to do all this. So we make the road by walking, and it's truly an honor to walk this road with you. Thank you so much.